I mean, what did you like about him? Because this could have easily been in maybe other hands, a less, you know, she said you could, you know, it could have been a villain character, but she didn't make it that way.
No, and I think that that's built one of the really smart things about the pilot is that there's, I don't know if you guys, I know you hadn't seen it, but you've read it or something like that?
They haven't seen it, but they saw a trailer.
Okay. We were briefed.
And
There's a
then
reveal in the pilot, like in the fourth act, that kind of shifts the paradigm a little bit to make it that you see that Abby, that Lisa's character, is complicit in the demise of this relationship as well. Which I think is really interesting and really smartly written because it's a little unexpected. And I love that challenge. I mean, I think that, I don't think he's a villain on the page at all. But it's also always a challenge to play the guy that maybe people aren't going to like very much. And you get to see why, you know, why they were together and why they're coming apart, too. You know, it makes people act poorly.
Well, we know that he is does have a new relationship, but
Yeah.
how is he dealing with his divorce and how is he dealing with like parenting part of the
I
time?
think that he's concerned. We're just getting into those episodes, and he is in this new relationship. They did have a, they do have an agreement that they're not going to introduce the kids to anybody significant until it's been discussed, until it's, it is legitimately significant. That rule gets broken, which I think happens, and that's an interesting thing to explore. And I think that he, you know, hasn't been in a very happy place for a number of years, both personally and professionally. And I don't think he wanted to get divorced, just like Abby did, but it just felt, I think it's just to them, it's dead. And they've kind of been living a lie. I mean, in the pilot, they're essentially separated, except living under the same roof, for the kids' sake. And that has taken its toll. And he's been pretty frustrated professionally, and that's taken its toll. So as he's launched out of this relationship, or launches himself out of this relationship, they, you see a guy, it's a bit, you know, there's an aspect of midlife crisis to it. You know, he starts wearing tighter clothes, and he gets the Porsche, and he gets a kind of maybe age-inappropriate girlfriend.
Never.
And I think that that's, you know, we've seen, you know, there are certain things that we call them cliches, but they're cliches because they happen a lot. And there, I think that what Marty's really good at is showing the psychology behind that kind of behavior, like why that happens, you know. And then she subverts it. How much I should reveal? But the woman who's, you know, the woman who plays Jake's new girlfriend, you know, it was really important. By Marty's description, that this is not some, this is somebody that, what's more infuriating to Abby is that this person's actually a smart, competent, nice woman. She's not some, she's not a bimbo, and she's not other cliches that you've seen. And so there's something about that that's even more threatening. It also, you know, doesn't really demonize Jake because you don't see him just, he's not just being totally superficial.
And well, tell us about you know, working with Bravo and I mean, had you seen, had you watched a lot of Bravo? Obviously, a lot of women watch Bravo.
I haven't watched a ton of Bravo. I love the Andy Cohen Show, so I do watch that.
What Happens
Yeah, I
Live.
watch What Happens Live. And
Have you met Andy Cohen yet?
I've not.
You might get to be on it.
That'd be exciting. You know, it's the viewership for that network is such an, it's such an exciting group to be making a piece of, you know, scripted content for because they're smart and engaged, and so I think this is going to really resonate.
Now that you are on Bravo, have you gone back and looked at some of the other programming?
Well, I've been in Canada, so there's Canadian Bravo, but it's different than
Right.
American Bravo. But when I can, I don't, you know, not, there's no TVs here.
Janine made a really good point about how it's a show about people and it's not necessarily like, of course it's targeted towards women, but it's not necessarily like only women will
Oh
enjoy
no,
it.
I don't think it doesn't have that. It's not that. I mean, I think that it is a co-viewing show, as they say. I mean, it really gets into. I mean, between Max and Dan, that's Janine's character's ex-husband, and my character, you really get the male side of it too. And I think that's important to Marty that you get to see the psychology of it. So I think it's going to
Yeah.
appeal to across the board.
Do they ever interact?
Oh yeah, a lot. Oh yeah, a lot. quite a bit.
A lot of bro time.
A lot of bro time. Well, there's this really interesting dynamic that Max, who's Abby's brother, is the one who introduced Jake and Abby, and that they've been very, very close. And he's married, and they have two kids. And he really doesn't like the fact that they're split. He really believes that marriage is forever, and they shouldn't be giving up. And he, the classic thing where, you know, a couple splits and who gets who is really thrown, you know, it's high stakes there because it's her brother, but she's still, Jake really leans on Max quite a bit. And that creates some tension with Abby as well. So I wouldn't say he has to choose, but there's a lot of pressure on that relationship.